On September 11th, 2020, an ambulance's seemingly routine journey through the German city of Dusseldorf was to prove a wake-up call for governments and institutions across the world. The patient on board, who required urgent surgery, was being transported to her nearest emergency care unit, the University Hospital, Dusseldorf. Unfortunately, the ambulance was rerouted by dispatch to Helios University Hospital, some 32 kilometers away. Soon after this unusually long ambulance trip, the patient died. The reason for the rerouting? A ransomware attack targeting the nearby Heinrich Heine University also hit the university hospital, shutting down crucial computer systems, throwing the hospital into disarray. Reports soon followed that this incident may have been the first ransomware attack with lethal consequences. But what is ransomware?
Ransomware is malicious software that either runs on your computer or on your phone, and it encrypts your files or locks your screen. And when that happens, a ransom note is displayed, which says that you can access your computer again or your files after you have paid the ransom. What happens, for example, if your wife, you know, or your partner, or your father, or your mother, she dies, you make some pictures of you with her the moment before she dies, and you really care about those pictures. And at one point, your computer gets infected with ransomware, which means you still have the files, but you cannot use them anymore. And you've lost your pictures of your recently deceased loved one. Ransomware can have a huge impact on the life of everyday people like you and me.
The first documented ransomware case in 1989, also a healthcare-related attack, demanded victims pay $189 to obtain a repair tool. Since then, ransomware attacks and profits have grown exponentially. In 2019, 187.9 million ransomware attacks were carried out worldwide. It is now estimated that ransomware generates over $1 billion per year for cybercriminals, and it's getting worse. The advent of COVID-19 has led to a greater reliance on digital technology. Shopping, education, and entertainment, even socializing, all became more digitally reliant. There has been a titanic shift in the way we go about our lives, but perhaps no single change has opened the doors to ransomware more than the mass societal shift towards remote working in response to the pandemic. It didn't take long for cybercriminals to recognize the opportunity. In the first quarter of 2020, insurance group Beazley reported a 25% increase in ransomware attacks. Since then, a raft of organizations have found themselves struggling to keep their perimeter defenses secure, with hackers knowing full well that most organizations were not adequately prepared for the rapid mass migration of devices outside of their secure corporate networks.
And now we see that also the vulnerabilities of the remote work are used for such ransomware attacks. The possibilities are huge, how people can get malware attacks.
Cybercriminals also began capitalizing on people's strong interest in coronavirus-related news, enticing people to click links to download malicious software. Of course, ransomware, with its ability to generate immediate profits, was the weapon of choice.
In North America last year, there were around 750 attacks on the healthcare sector, and during the pandemic, this number has risen continuously.
Honestly, I was not very surprised. The different attacks were demanding lives probably also earlier in different other sectors. It's a different story if it was written somewhere or not, or was it published or not.
In 2017, there was the WannaCry attack on the healthcare sector, and it's very clear that there was an upwards trend of attacks of this type.
The most painful is that we are talking about the hospital. We are talking about life science. They are in the focus of such attacks.
It's only natural at a certain stage that there are going to be human costs, these sort of attacks, and the Dusseldorf case is a very clear demonstration of this.
After months of investigation, the police concluded that the woman likely would have died regardless of which hospital she was admitted to. The district chief's prosecutor likened it to hitting a dead body while driving. Still, the Dusseldorf case remains a warning sign, calling for action in the world of cybersecurity.
According to the law, there was no causation, but that does not mean that the ransomware attack did not contribute sufficiently to the death of this woman.
Governments, institutions, and companies are working hard to catch up with these cyber attacks, bolstering their investment in cybersecurity and implementing policies to fight back against ransomware perpetrators. In the wake of the events, the region where the attack took place is set to receive over 100 million euros in federal funds to improve IT security. But what can be done on an individual level? How can we keep ourselves safe?
Make sure not to click on any suspicious emails. Always use strong and different passwords for each account and install the latest security patches. And in case that it goes wrong, make sure that you have backups installed on your computer.
Just like in real life, to eliminate viruses, we use vaccines. In the cyber world, we can stop the spread of such viruses and malware by limiting the amount of unprotected computers. Installing cybersecurity is the best way to achieve this, but for those who do fall victim to ransomware, there is hope. More and more police are working with private companies to find innovative ways to help the victims.
So No More Ransom started as a project by Kaspersky, McAfee, the Dutch police and Europol as a project where we really wanted to help victims of ransomware. So for that, we created the website, and on that website you can see how to report a crime. But most importantly, you can also find out with which ransomware version you are infected and whether there is a decryption tool available. And if that's the case, it gives a link to the decryption tool. You can download it and then you can decrypt your files for free.
In the Dusseldorf case, the local police were able to reach the hackers, having found the ransom note that had been left on one of the clinic's servers. They realized that the letter was actually addressed to the Heinrich Heine University in Dusseldorf, and not the nearby university hospital. When the police notified the hackers of the mix-up and warned them that many patients were now at risk, the hackers thankfully withdrew their extortion and handed over the digital key. Ransomware has the potential to do serious damage, not just to the bottom line of companies or to the operations of government agencies, but on an individual level. A ransomware attack could have grave consequences. The Dusseldorf incident was a stark reminder of ransomware's potential to harm.